Joining me now is Wayne Hiley. He is the Managing Director and CEO over at Peninsula Energy. Good to see you again, Wayne.
Hello, Mark. It's great to be joining you on the program again.
So let's get an update here. You've decided to bring resin processing in-house. So what's the immediate focus right now?
Well, for Peninsula, that decision was sort of forced on us. For a long time, we've relied on a resin processing contractor to treat our loaded uranium loaded resins. And that contractor has given us notice that they no longer want to provide that service to us. So our immediate focus, Mark, is to become an independent uranium yellow cake producer, to bring the yellow the resin processing in-house and have the in-house capability to produce dry uranium yellow cake, a final product that's sellable. And we're going to place all of our energy into that and putting that those circuits in at the Lance facilities and delivering our sizable and important Lance project back into production.
Wayne, what's the timeline to complete and release the revised plan? Do you know that yet?
Yeah, Mark, we've already been working on that plan. A lot of detail goes into it. What we're trying to prepare is how much time it's going to take for us to build the new circuits in the plant and how much money it's going to take. And that all depends on the availability of materials and contractors to do the work. We're making those assessments now, and we really hope to have the information completed and available for public release before the end of the month of August.
All right, very good. Now, just curious, why wouldn't Peninsula utilize UEC services for about 9 months or so for the Lance projects? What went into that decision?
Well, we're restarting our project, and we're right at the cusp of getting the project going. Once you start an in-situ recovery well field, and particularly of concern is in a low pH well field, which is what we'd be doing, we believe that it's best to keep it running until it's fully depleted. Having only a nine-month window of operations would mean that we would not be able to complete and get full recovery from our well fields. And if you have to stop because you have nowhere to go with your loaded resins, you risk losing the significant asset, the remaining uranium that's recoverable in the well fields. It's really best to finish what you start in in-situ recovery well field world. So we made the choice that it's going to be better to start the well fields as a fully independent and unreliant producer than it is to start the well fields and then shut them down for a period of time while we complete the plant construction and then restart them, because you could lose that asset and you put a lot of money into well fields.
So how does the delay in production affect your 2024 sales commitment? So what's the impact?
Right. We have a contract book that's over 4.8 million pounds of deliveries over the next decade, extending out to 2023. And we certainly had deliveries that were scheduled for late 2023 and the year 2024. We're working with our customers. We're in discussions with our customers about deliveries that might be impacted by the delay in the restart. You know, we were going to be restarting here around mid-year. Now we're looking at providing guidance on when that restart will be able to occur, later in the month of August. So we have maintained very strong relationships with our customer base, and we know them to be flexible, open, and supportive of the U.S. uranium industry. I believe that we'll be able to adjust the delivery schedule to the satisfaction of our customers and proceed with our business without significant impact to our business or to the business of our customers.
And Wayne, can you take us through the rest of 23 and what the key areas of focus are?
Yeah, well, our full focus and energy is going to be on developing the in-house capabilities, constructing and implementing the plan that, we're developing right now. We'll also be working on continuing to construct the plant that we've, the work that's been ongoing since the beginning of the year. We're going to finish that plant modifications, add the new circuits to the process, and drill in continue wellfield development drilling. Wellfield development drilling is a really important facet of in situ recovery, and you know, we're preparing mine unit 3, and we'll focus on mine unit 3 and beyond, so that we'll have more wellfields available to us when we do restart. Having more new wellfields available means that you can ramp up production quicker, and you can have a much more cost efficient project from the very get-go. So we're excited about that aspect, that we'll be able to complete a lot more wellfield development in advance of starting production. It's kind of like putting an ore stockpile at your mill, having wellfields ready to go. That's going to be a big focus for us. We're also going to work on some of the backlogged exploration and delineation and resource drilling efforts that we've been planning to do for a while. So very shortly, we'll be beginning a drilling campaign in our Kendrick area to upgrade some of the inferred resources, and we'll have drill results coming to the public over the course of the year as well.
All right, very good. We'll be looking forward to that. Now, lastly, and more broadly within the sector, we see interest and demand for nuclear energy and uranium in kind growing. And so can you give us your explanation, your view as to why nuclear energy is a key component and critical to a transition to a clean energy future?
Well, governments across the world, we're seeing it. They're committing to aggressive carbon reduction targets in their energy production profiles, and nuclear energy is growing in importance across the sector of energy production around the globe. Uranium is the fuel for nuclear energy, and uranium has been growing in importance. So the long-term fundamentals for uranium are just outstanding right now. We have a supply and demand situation where more supply is needed. There's growing demand. Uranium production is limited and not meeting the current demand. We need to grow uranium production for not only the current demand, but to meet the future demand, the increasing future demand, the pressures of decarbonization of our energy grids around the world are going to put a lot of demand into the market for uranium. So there's this growing interest in the uranium sector, combined with, you know, Lance being a pre-production operation, really has created a lot of enthusiasm for Peninsula. Over the course of the last quarter, you know, when I was out doing non-deal roadshows and investor presentations, we had a tremendous amount of interest in the company. Now, that was done before, you know, this turn of events where we've had to shift our strategy. But we believe that the long-term value of Peninsula in this evolving market, that proposition has fundamentally not changed. We have a tremendous opportunity with a very high resource project that we're going to put into production. It won't be tomorrow, but it's going to be soon. And I think the current investors in Peninsula Energy will be pleased with the outcomes of the evaluations that we're currently doing.
Well, investors have an opportunity now that the stock's on sale a little bit. So we'll see how that goes. And we appreciate the update. We'll talk to you soon. And we appreciate your time, Wayne. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Mark. It's great to talk with you.
Okay. Wayne Hiley, Managing Director and CEO at Peninsula Energy. Thanks a lot for joining us. We'll talk to you next time.